Thanks very much, Adrian. Can everyone hear me? Okay. So as Adrian said, I a few months ago released this essay and gave an invited talk at AsiaCrypt on the moral character of cryptographic work. My remarks there were very much intended for the cryptographic community, and the cryptographic community isn't identical, certainly, to the folks who do security and come here. There's certainly an intersection, and part of my underlying complaints, I believe, is precisely that these communities are not very well connected, which I hope and see signs of changing. There were, I think, three themes in the essay. The first is that cryptography rearranges power relations. This is, in some sense, its most basic goal. We're trying to ensure that which the adversary can do is different from that which good participants can do. And because power relations are the essence of politics, this means that intrinsically, cryptography impacts politics, that it's political. And since politics is really about who has what power in society. And because who has what power in society shapes very much the character of modern society, this means that cryptography is de facto something of moral significance. The third theme is that it has become incumbent on cryptographers to find more effective means to address the problem of mass surveillance. These three themes all, I think, have a kind of mirror image in the security community, but I will continue my focus on speaking towards cryptographers, since this is the community that I know. I worry, however, that because the communities are different, that it might be that you already believe much of the things I'm trying to say today. And I had intended the talk and the corresponding essay to be at least somewhat controversial or provocative, and I may fail on this account. I hope I'm not simply preaching to the choir, and I guess perhaps I'll know from your questions whether I am. I guess I'll promise not to preach too much, and you don't have to sing. That is pretty jittery. The essay was very difficult to write, and I think part of the problem is that I was trying to combine two aspects of what I do that in the past I've always treated as separate. On the one hand, I spend most of my time doing crypto research and writing papers, but at my university, I spend a lot of my time actually teaching ethics. Starting in 2004, I created a class called Ethics in an Age of Technology. The title actually stolen from this book by Ian Barber, a physicist and religious studies scholar. And I didn't view these domains as particularly well connected. It was important to me to teach an ethics class, but I didn't think that what I did in my real life, crypto, was connected enough to even include cryptography or privacy topics in the class. It wasn't that I thought they had no moral import, but rather that in the face of kind of existential questions about, you know, whether or not humans and the biosphere will recognizably exist in another 100 or 200 years, these just seemed like minor questions. My assessment changed a few years ago, and I'll describe why. In order to take in context,